After 10 weeks of lockdown, with cases still climbing, tension has turned into anger. Coordinated protests erupted across Sydney and the state, organised and spread via social media and with barely a mask in sight. Demonstrations flared in the suburbs, including hotspots. Taking a wider look, there were similar outbursts in regional areas. Now, they've come on the day cases fell, but are stubbornly refusing to move significantly. That's despite restrictions, as we approach 100 deaths in this latest outbreak. There is a huge amount of pressure on our hospitals too, and the staff, particularly in intensive care. Tonight, a gripping, emotional account of what really goes on inside a system under immense strain. But when it comes to vaccines, well, we're flying. Single dose numbers approaching 7 million for adults, with more than 36% fully vaccinated. Now, the Premier says her goal is to reunite families by Christmas.
It is the longest lockdown this state has ever seen, and some are now at breaking point.
Get out of my face!
Okay, sir, don't yell at me again or you'll be arrested.
This is being treated like a criminal. I'm a taxpayer.
Anti-lockdown protests coordinated on social media saw council chambers surrounded, from Byron Bay to Sydney's beaches.
Hopefully the country will wake up and see what this government's doing to us.
And even the hotspot council areas, including Fairfield and Bayside. In total, 69 separate protests, some small, some silent, but all with the message, for these people, at least, they've had enough.
Children that have been mentally scarred for life, people without food on their tables, we have to work out a better way forward. Draconian lockdowns and control is not the way forward.
135 people were arrested.
It's unconstitutional, they're arresting me without righteous cause.
And police again wore the brunt of the anger.
You're putting your heads down. You know.
No need to swear. Today's actions only further serve to jeopardise the freedoms of those people who are doing the right thing.
The Health Minister also not holding back.
You will always have a certain group who unfortunately are spending more time on social media and listening to people with crackpot ideas than you will have perhaps reading the scientific journals and talking to the doctors.
The lockdown, as painful as it's been, has demonstrated that we have managed to keep case numbers relatively, I know this is confronting, low, lower than what would have happened otherwise.
A difficult message to deliver as the state records another 1,164 cases and three more deaths.
Go and get vaccinated as fast as you can.
But appointments are proving difficult to get. Some young people outside of the hotspot areas told, we are unable to offer you an appointment at this time.
Can I say unashamedly, we have prioritised the people of southwestern Sydney and western Sydney for vaccines.
They are where 80% of today's cases were found, but there's also concern infections are rising in Camden, the Inner West, Randwick and Ryde. An explosion too in infections inside Parklea Prison. 74 inmates and one staff member now positive.
I've identified previously that prisons are vulnerable settings, and it's been pleasing that we have been progressively rolling out vaccination to our corrective services staff.
As they try to convince the public to stick to the plan, the Premier is offering a glimpse of what life may look like when we hit 80% fully vaccinated, including potentially reopening the international border, even if other states are still locking us out.
Well, that is a conversation we'll have with the Prime Minister, with our National Cabinet colleagues.
And while that's up in the air, they are now considering home quarantine for fully vaccinated arrivals.
When you have Aussies coming home that are fully vaccinated, I think home quarantine is a logical place.
Promising a better future ahead for those willing to stay the course.
Well, Ursula's with me now. Ursula, the situation's not getting any better in our regional areas.
Well, Sandra, no, we are still seeing very high cases in the state's west and far west. The most are still centred around Dubbo, 32 cases there, but they are also being detected in Wellington, Bathurst, Bourke and Parkes, as well as four more in Wilcannia in the far west. And remember, the regions were due to come out of lockdown in 10 days' time. That now doesn't seem very likely. Sandra, the Health Minister today said they are now in the process of getting approvals for pop-up emergency accommodation, including potentially camper vans around the Broken Hill area, to try to limit the spread of the virus within large families.
We need solutions now. Thank you, Ursula.